Hi, do you have a shy dog that struggles saying hi to strangers in your house or on walks? I'm Camille with Positive Futures Dog Training and Behavior, and today we're going to work on the approach and retreat technique to help a dog be more comfortable saying hi to people, a stranger, on the walk or inside the house. So if your dog is, you know, weary of strangers inside the home and tends to bark when people come in the house, I find it very useful to do the greeting on leash so that it's a little bit easier to move your dog to and from without them just being stuck kind of like too close and barking. It's also very useful to do greetings either in the backyard or even in the front yard or even at a park somewhere neutral. Nice open space so that you can have the big distance that your dog needs from, you know, between him, her, or the stranger. And that way you can kind of gradually get closer and closer without them feeling like they're trapped or too close too quickly. And so the approach and retreat technique is very useful in building a dog's confidence because they get to kind of escape when things get a little bit too scary. And because they realize they can leave the situation, they feel like they don't have to bark and keep the scary thing away. They can actually move themselves away and get the distance that they want. And so typically I start at a point where my dog knows that there's a trigger. So he has seen the person standing there, but not so close that they're already reacting and barking. And I'll start walking forward. I usually will do two steps at a time, right? Because I don't want to pressure my dog to go too far too fast. But I do want my dog to engage with the trigger, so I want them to walk towards it and see it. And then when they kind of lock eyes with the stranger, that's usually when I'll mark or call my dog's name. So in this case, Lola! And I got her to turn around and rewarded her away so that she gets rewarded for disengaging from the scary thing. Instead of staring at it and barking at it to try to make it go away, she walks away and she gets a yummy, yummy cookie. And on top of that, she gets the nice release of pressure because she doesn't have to look at the scary thing anymore. Just, and then she has a nice little break while she finds the treat on the floor, gives her mind the time to kind of go, okay, that was scary. Okay, ready? Let's do it again. And same thing, I'll do a step or two forward again. My dog kind of pauses and sees the trigger. I'll say their name or yes to get their attention, walk them away and reward them on the floor so that they have to go find a treat and again get a little bit of a mental break as they're looking for the treat instead of just eating the cookie and going right back to staring at the trigger. As we get closer, and you know how close really depends on your dog and how sensitive they are and what their threshold is. But when I start getting close to the point where my dog is visibly getting a little bit more nervous, so might be huffing, might actually start barking a little bit more as we're approaching, might be getting tense. It might be more difficult to get my dog to turn around because they're getting a little bit stuck staring at the scary thing. Usually at that point, I like to pause at the same level, right? So I'll take my two steps forward, my dog sees, yes, good job. I'll reward behind me, but then I'll stay there for between 3 to 5 repetitions, and I'll reward my dog for just looking at the trigger. Yes, good job, and I'll mark and reward right away. Oftentimes, I also like to ask my dog for a sit, and not because I want my dog to sit and look, I just want to gauge how receptive my dog is to known cues. So sit is pretty common, easy cue. If I ask for a sit and my dog sits right away, I know their brain is thinking and working and we can probably take one step closer. If I'm asking for the sit and my dog is not able to do it, that tells me that my dog is stressed out. And even though they might not be reacting, they can't focus and do a very simple command that they know very well. So that usually means I'll either stay at this level and do a couple more of watch and yes, treat, right? So my dog is getting rewarded for calmly watching the trigger, or I might actually take a step back. And same thing, pause there, reward my dog for looking at stuff, ask for a sit. So as my dog gets more comfortable at that level, then I'll start going forward again. So again, you know, how close and how fast you get to the person is completely dependent on your dog. Your dog is the one deciding how quickly you can move forward and how long you have to stay in one location. Again, we don't want to pressure our dogs to go say hi and get close before they're ready, because that usually leads to them having a really big reaction. And in the future, they're going to be even more sensitized because they got forced and I couldn't escape and I was stuck and I had to go say hi and I had no way out. And they'll probably start reacting even sooner. So you do want to take your time. If you find that, you know, your dog can't get past 15, 10 feet without getting really nervous, what I recommend is taking a walk with the person, right? So kind of parallel walking, the person is about 10, 15 feet and casually walking together. And you can kind of gradually kind of sway in and then sway out so that your dog gets used to the presence of the stranger without having to have that kind of really lots of pressure, like having to do face-to-face contacts. And as they warm up and settle down and calm down, then you can do kind of repeat the approach and retreat at just a shorter distance.
Awesome. In order to play this game, you will need to have some leash manners and attention on cue. If you need help with that, check out these two videos.